The Egyptian cobra's venom is super toxic. Even in tiny quantities, it can kill relatively big animals. But the Egyptian cobra, as well as pretty much every other toxic animal, has to produce and store those deadly chemicals inside its own body. So why don't toxic animals hurt themselves? Hi, I'm Cameron, and this is Minute Earth. The first, and probably most obvious, way to avoid kicking your own bucket is to make sure your poison doesn't work on you, which is a strategy many poison dart frogs use. When their poison gets on another critter, it snaps into specially shaped receptors in that animal's nerves, eventually stopping its heart. But the poison doesn't affect the frog itself, because the frog has evolved a slightly different version of that nerve protein, changing its shape just enough to prevent the poison from ever latching on. Another option is to have a way to soak up your own poison before it can kill you, like the pitohui, a tropical bird that puts poison in its feathers. In order to keep itself safe from its own poison, it produces proteins in its bloodstream that act like sponges that stick to, and basically disarm, poison molecules. The next strategy is even simpler. Simply store your toxins in a place where they can't hurt you, like murder hornets and black widow spiders do. Both of these animals are susceptible to their own venom, but their weaponry is located in a place where it is walled off from the rest of the body, and for them, it's physically impossible to unleash it on themselves. And finally, you could store your toxins in an inactive form, like the slow loris, the world's only venomous primate, does. The toxin the loris secretes from its armpits is completely harmless on its own. It's only when the animal licks its armpit, putting the venom in contact with saliva, that the venom becomes activated. And when the loris subsequently bites an enemy, that venom gets transferred to the bite wound, where it causes the victim's flesh to rot away. Because carrying deadly chemical weapons inside your own body is such a high-stakes situation, lots of toxic species actually use more than one of these strategies to stay safe. Which brings us back to the Egyptian cobra, which uses all four methods to protect itself from its own venom. The snake has those modified nerve proteins that make it immune to the nerve-paralyzing toxin in its venom. But since that venom is a cocktail that contains other toxins too, the snake also stores it in walled-off glands. Beyond just locking the venom away, these glands also temporarily inactivate the venom in part by bathing it in acids. It only becomes reactivated in a basic environment, like its victim's blood. And if the venom happens to leak into the snake's own blood, a sponge-like protein in its bloodstream mops up the toxins before they do any harm. In other words, if you're going to be venomous or poisonous, use protection. If you're a snake and you want to level up your game, you develop chemical weapons. And if you are a human and you want to level up your career, you develop, well, developer skills. Boot.dev, which sponsored this video, has created an easy way to learn back-end web development in languages like Go and Python. Hey, another snake! They've gamified the whole learning process, so as you learn to code, you'll earn XP, levels, achievements, and even get to complete quests. All the game features on boot.dev are designed to keep you motivated and moving toward your goal, job-ready programming skills. And all of this is within a system specially designed to have you writing a ton of code, because, well, the best way to learn is by doing. Click the link in the description and use the code MinuteEarth to get 25% off your first month, or even off your entire first year if you choose the annual plan. Thanks, boot.dev.